So there are different nano structures. That is the structure of some plants. So they can see that they are again having a nano structures at the upper end. It is a highly magnified images. So the if you could explore the different materials, deep, so they will have the different nano structures, and they are responsible for changing the different properties. So we can have the different shaped nano materials. They are artificially made materials. We have shown earlier they were the nature materials, but these are the artificial made materials. These are the nano wires are being made, and this is the different shape of the material, nano balls, that kind of structure. They are the porous material. By the lithography or this etching process, we are being fabricated these kind of materials. They are again the hollow rods. These are the hollow rods. You see that they are hollow inside and very much aligned. The structures are being grown. So then other nano structures are being formed. This is a nano flower. That is the nano flower morphology formed. So I told you that morphology is basically atom start attaching to each other. How they are attaching, accordingly the shape they will adopt. Suppose they are attaching in all three direction, and accordingly they may get a flower shape. If they are attaching, they are growing only one direction, only length across the diameter, their growth is restricted, then they can become these fibers or the rod, nano balls. They can be like a fluorine structure. So the different, these are again hollow rods. So this is a rabbit kind of a structure is being obtained by someone. So you could say that it is a rabbit formation of some material. So the morphology, that depending upon how atoms are attaching to each other, how they are growing, and what kind of the shape they are obtained. So that the shape of the nanomaterials we can get. So that is nanomaterials. They have the unique property. I told you the starting catalytic property, electrical, magnetic, mechanical, optical, electrical, biological. So all of these property, they got changed. Catalytic property because of surface to volume ratio. Electrical property, we can tune the band gap. Even magnetic property got changed. Materials, they could become very hard and tough because of the nano dimensions. Their optical property changed because of changing band gap. Biological properties, because that you can change the drugs. If we can make them at nanometric level, then their efficacy can be improved and they can become more biocompatible. So there are a lot of scope in the nanomaterials, and they have the unique property they show once we reduce their size and shape. So that is the example of the carbon CDAC nanotubes. So we have made the CDAC nanoparticle at the different size. 13 nanometer, 14, 17, 19, 24. So their color is different. So because if you change the size, then the band gap change. So because of changing the band gap, the color will not change. So we can do the different things can be done by changing the size of the particles. So I think we have to stop at this point. So other things are then the fabrication method of nanoparticles. It is again the vast topic. So we cannot cover up. So in the remaining time, we will have some discussion with you that what are the doubt in your mind, there is any query, curiosity related to that. So we can do the thank you for you people and to connecting with us. So that is the this nano technology and the nature I told you. One more thing I want to tell you, that either you may be a student or either you are doing some job, that we are also working on that the skill development. That is a very important thing in the coming time. You have to improve your skills in the whatever things you are reading, then you have to improve your skill. Skill means, suppose you are a civil engineer, you are studying the structural engineering. So it means you have the knowledge of structural engineering, but if you could convert this knowledge by using this structural engineering knowledge, if you can make a good building, so it means you also have the skill of this civil engineering. So thing is that we have to improve our skills. So if we have the skills, then we could not search to the job, but we can become the entrepreneur. We can give the jobs to us. So we are also working on that. You can interact with us. You can join with us our YouTube channel, Youth Skill Development Forum, where we can guide you that how you can improve your skills, how you can start your startup, your business. You can go for that. So you can subscribe our channel, Youth Skill Development Forum on YouTube. So thank you for all connecting with us through this webinar. And now I would be happy to take the questions from the participants.
Thank you, sir, for your presentation today. Webinar was excellent, very informative. We appreciate the insights. इंफॉर्मेशन दिए आगे जो है क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन के लिए बढ़ेंगे तो कितनी बार कोई क्वेश्चन हो तो कृपया आप अपनी माइक अनम्यूट करके क्वेश्चन रेज करें. सेकंड थिंग आप
सर देयर मे बी सम क्वेश्चन इन द चैट बॉक्स आइदर यू कुड टेक फ्रॉम द चैट बॉक्स.
आप चैट बॉक्स में भी क्वेश्चन है वो रेज कर सकते हैं. कृपया सभी पार्टिसिपेंट से आग्रह है आप सभी चैट बॉक्स में अपनी क्वेश्चन रेज करें. सर वन ऑफ आशीष यादव जी का वन क्वेश्चन है हाउ कैन बी यूज टू अटेन सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट.
हाउ द नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी कैन बी यूज फॉर
अटेन सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट.
ओके so sustainable development it is a very common thing that I am not understand it what kind of the sustainable development they are talking about because the nanotechnology is basically change in the material. So change in the material will change in the property so it will sustainable in that case only once you will not change the material conditions means if you change the temperature if you change the pressure then only the structure could modify and the material property could modify. So materials property they may also change in the environment but every material have their property in a specific range of the temperature environment. Once you change the environment then only change will be there in the property otherwise they will remain sustainable and they can be shown for the even longer duration.
Thank you sir. शिवम मैनी जी का क्वेश्चन है हाउ नैनोटेक्नोलॉजी हेल्प इन इफेक्टिव एंड एफिशिएंट यूज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड डेवलपमेंट.
एफिशिएंट फॉर विच डेवलपमेंट.
टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट.
टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट सो यू नो दैट इट इज अ टेक्नोलॉजी सो नाउ इन द कमिंग टाइम्स आइदर यू सी दैट हाउ मच साइज ऑफ द mobiles is being reduces it all because of nanotechnology. We are using the creams, even the creams they are made by the in the cosmetics they are made by the nanotechnology. Drugs they are coming by using the nanotechnology, that's why they have the high efficacy. So it is very vast. You can have every now in the coming time drug targeting, we are talking about the drug targeting, chemotherapy. So everywhere nanotechnology is used. Even the cloths are made by the nanotechnology and those cloths have the property dust cannot stick your cloth, so there is no need to washing the cloth if you are making the nanotechnology based cloths. So the scope is everywhere, even into the computers, electronics. Now the suppose they are making the cement of the civil people, so the civil if they are using nano size particles their strength is very strong, large. So it is a wide scope of the nanotechnology. So it will grow in the India. There is not at this the booming stage, but in the coming time you will see that there will be a lot of development by using that.
Thank you sir. Dr. Vibhu Bhushan Sarangi ji ka question hai, what are the limitations on nanotechnology?
Limitations is there that first thing is once you are working in that field, so nanoparticles they are very very smaller and very smaller in that way, so we cannot do it. Suppose you are working on nanotechnology, so we have to use the proper mask during the working environment, otherwise the nanoparticle they may go inside our body through the inhalation. So that thing is there. So we have to make some precautions. And other limitation is now that some cost is higher. So once the material will become cheaper, once this technology will be more generalized, so the cost will reduce, then everyone will take the advantage of this technology by reducing the cost of the materials. One question is also, what is the use of nanotechnology in bio, so biotechnology?
Yes, sir.
So biotechnology is a lot of use. So in the drug targeting, you know that now people are using the drug targeting, like magnetic drug targeting. So in magnetic drug targeting, what we do, we use the magnetic nanoparticles. We attach the drug with these particles and near the tumor or whatever is the cancer cells. So we introduce the drug and we can control the drug movement by external magnetic field. So then the drug particle, they will only reach only to your tumor portion. It will not spread throughout the body. Like chemotherapy, if we take, then that chemical, they will spread in our whole body. And there are a lot of side effects. Our hairs will remove and all that. But in targeted drug delivery, the drug will be, that will be only inside your, at around your tumor site. So we can control from the external magnetic field. So then you require the magnetic nanoparticle. Hyperthermia is there. Magnetic nanoparticle we can send and they can generate the temperature. Because at the temperature of 37 degrees centigrade, we can burn the cancerous cell. But it should not go beyond to the 37. Otherwise, the healthy cells will also burn. So there are a lot of field in biotechnology. Drugs, I told you that already. The drugs, now they are being growth at the molecular atomic levels. So then their efficacy is being improved and their the drugs, the properties is improved.
Thank you, sir. Anita Raya, ma'am question. What are the environmental impact of nanotechnology?
What are the
environmental impact?
Environmental impact, you see, it will vary material to material, that what is the environmental impact. So generally, the material of the nano material, they are formed in the vacuum environment. In most of the time, if you are making the high quality of materials, they are also can be burned up in the open environment. So in that case, you must have, suppose you are working on the chemical route for the nanomaterial synthesis. So you must have that the proper arrangement that during the formation of material, some fumes are coming. So they cannot be sent openly to the environment. We could collect them in the chamber and then otherwise it may have the harm for the environment also. So even the, there are also some so they can be used in the war. So you can spread the poisonous nanoparticle to the opposite army, and once they will inhale, so they may die or they may can be unconscious. So that kind of the limitations and some the misuse also can be done of this field. So
थैंक यू सर, आपने पहले ही क्वेश्चन का आंसर दे चुके हैं, लेकिन फिर भी मैं उसको दो, एक और क्वेश्चन साहिबो जी का है. व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंट रोल प्ले इन मेडिकल इंडस्ट्री?
मेडिकल इंडस्ट्री तो यस यस मेडिकल इंडस्ट्री, यू नो द ड्रग फॉर्मेशन. सो ड्रग ग्रोथ इज ऑल्सो एट द एटॉमिक मॉलिक्यूलर लेवल. सो देयर आर द डिफरेंट रूट्स ऑफ द ड्रग्स फॉर्मेशन, द ग्रोथ. So by that we could changing the process of the growth of the material. So it will change their molecular shape. The shape of the particle can be changed and accordingly the property of our drugs can be changed. So that is in the field of medical science.
Surabhi Gupta, ma'am, question hai. How the nanotechnology can be useful for reducing waste?
Reducing waste.
Yes.
So you see that we are also working in some of the part of the waste material for utilization. So in our region, particularly into the Haryana and near the Delhi. So during the time of the rice cultivation, there is also the rice paddy part that is known as the parali. So the farmer generally burn this parali openly into the field. So that create a lot of environmental problems. So there are some methane gas are there, and there are the PM2.5 level particles. So these particles, they go to our lungs, and they are very, very dangerous. Asthma and kind of the disease are being formed. So this the environmental effect is the waste material, they can be converted into the wealth. Like we have been make a process by using the nanotechnology methods, that this rice husk, rice straw, and the sugarcane bagasse, that is the sugarcane bagasse is extracted after extracting the juice from the sugarcane. So by using this material, we are making the energy storage device. We are making activated carbon for water purification. We are making energy material, super capacitors and batteries by using this waste material. So that is a very good question. And there are a lot of things are being going on in the coming time, that waste is being utilized. The waste is converted into wealth by using the nanotechnology. So nanotechnology methods are being used for their conversion into the different applications.
Thank you, sir. Kuldeep Kaur's question is, how can you use nanotechnology in computer science?
How we can use nanotechnology for?
Computer science.
Oh, computer science. You see that computer science, the hardware part that is related to the programming. So in programming, you see that some formula are being used. Suppose I am doing a programming for a atoms and molecules. So once the algorithm is being written, so any the computer program, what change must be there? The change will be into the equations. Equation has to be changed to make any model. So once you make the equations, then what have to be used? If you are working at the nanometric scale, then you use the quantum formulation, not the classical. So you have to replace our classical formulation into the quantum formulation for atomic and molecular programming. So the people, they are working for making the models. There are a lot of simulation modeling work is going on in the nanotechnology. So before making any the IC or any device, any VLSI or the chip, so generally, firstly, they do the simulation. So they make the computer program. They do the modeling. So in the modeling, we have to use the equations. So the equations has to be, those equations are being based upon the quantum physics, because quantum physics work in the nanomaterials. So accordingly, we have to use our different techniques, the programs, DFT calculations and all that, they have to be changed once we work into the atomic and molecular levels. So programming equations naturally has to be changed for the nanometric dimensions.
Also, Yamraj, you have one question, sir. How can you use nanotechnology in food industry?
Food industry. Yes, for the food industry, that there are major challenges that we have to be want that it, the we can preserve the food for the longer duration. So for that, we use the different materials. You see that earlier we used the silver wafer. You have seen in the sweets. Over the sweets, there is a very thin layer of the silver, that is wafer. So this silver have a very good antibacterial activity properties. So similarly, the nano dimensions, the antibacterial property improved. So by using that kind of nanomaterials, we can preserve more the food for the longer period. And that is the major use of the nanotechnology in the food industry as well.
Thank you, sir.
Which is
the time I'm already 6 minutes work for me. So my condition to say, सारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स की ओर से, अभाव फाउंडेशन की ओर से आपने जो समय दिया, इससे भी मैं पुनः आपको एक बार धन्यवाद करता हूँ. और आपसे अपेक्षा हमें भविष्य में रहेगी, क्योंकि हमारा ये टॉपिक पूरा नहीं हुआ है, तो भविष्य में ही हम उसको एक बार और आगे बढ़ा के एक बार और विचार करना चाहेंगे. इसके लिए हम आपसे समय एप्रोप्रिएट टाइम में एडजस्ट करेंगे, आप हमें समय देंगे और यहाँ आए. उसके लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. एक बात जो सर ने बताई है, स्किल डेवलपमेंट को लेके गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया जो है वो बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है. तो सर ने जो यूट्यूब लिंक है या अदर जो सोशल साइट है वो बताएं, तो प्लीज उसको लाइक और सब्सक्राइब जरूर करें.
और अभी जैसे अभी कोरोना खत्म होने के जैसे ही खत्म होगा, So we have the plan that we will have some lectures in the different colleges, different schools, because our purpose is that we have to motivate our students for the skill development. Then only the unemployment problem can be addressed. So we will do the lecture in different colleges. So you can ask, then we can come even to your college, or either you can organize the webinars till then. So that is the, we have to be work on that. So for any updation, you can join us our YouTube channel, Youth Skill Development Forum. So there you can write us for if you want any lecture related to that from your school, college. So then happily we will available for that.
Thank you, sir. पार्टिसिपेंट सभी से आग्रह है जो यूट्यूब चैनल है उसको जरूर लॉग इन करें, क्योंकि बहुत सारी इंफॉर्मेटिव इंफॉर्मेशन उसे अवेलेबल है, और आप यूज करेंगे तो उससे रिलेटेड और भी इंफॉर्मेशन उसमें अपलोड की जाएगी। साथ ही साथ आप सभी कनेक्ट रहेंगे, सभी लोग साथ रहेंगे, तो वो सर जो है और ज्यादा अच्छे से, या जो भी उनके और पार्टिसिपेंट्स है वो अच्छे से लोग कंटेंट प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं। थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू वंस अगेन,
थैंक यू सभी, थैंक यू, धन्यवाद सभी का जुड़ने के लिए।
हाँ, सभी से आग्रह है, आप सभी जो है अटेंडेंस फॉर्म जो है चैट बॉक्स में दी हुई है, आज की अटेंडेंस कोड है 111, तो कृपया सभी आप सभी अटेंडेंस फॉर्म फिल करके जाएं, ताकि हम आपको सर्टिफिकेट ऑफर में आपकी ईमेल आईडी पे सेंड कर पाएं।